Hello and welcome all you battlefielders out there. You know who it is. Shut the fuck up, cat. Be quiet. I'm trying to do a commentary. It's your boy. It's Gyro, the console scrub, and my cat is screaming in the background. If you did not hear that, meow, and whatever else. But anyways, today, the gameplay that you are seeing on the Xbox 360, which I currently play on, of course, is my game before. My level 100, my level 99. That's right, I finally hit my level 100 for Battlefield 3. Only took me over 600 hours of playing the game like I do. I do not stick to any certain playlist or map in particular. I like to float around and do everything, so I don't think it's too bad, but I hit it last Friday, and I'm pretty happy. I will be having a video come out to show you guys me hitting my level 100, but anyways, we're going to be talking about Endgame. It is now live for PS3 Premium members, along with a game update brought lots of fixes. So if you are playing on PS3 or PC, today you should be encountering, or yesterday you should have been encountering a update. For us Xbox users, we should be able to download the update no later than March 12th. So, of course, as you know, all PS3 Premium members got access to Endgame, which is the brand new DLC, and PC and Xbox 360 users will get it next Tuesday. So, we only have to wait a little bit. Hope you PS3 people have lots of fun on it, because once I get it, amazing things are gonna happen. And I got a clip to show you guys too. I mean, once I hit my level 100, it seems like I've gained superpowers of being able to just do amazing shit. Like, I took out an AC-130 with a mobile artillery, and not with the AA-like launcher on it, but actual missiles from across the map, so you guys will probably be seeing that uploaded on GameSprout, or maybe Amazing Films 24/7 if they accept it, you know. So here's a few tweaks and fixes that they did to the game that you guys will now notice. The TV missile should no longer be able to blow up the helicopter shooting the missile. They also change the scavenger mode ticket count in Aftermath from 150 to 300 to create matches that last a bit longer, because I'd say in 100% tickets, games only last 6 to 7 minutes on console, which is 12v12. They have also fixed the incorrect spelling on Aftermath dog tags. Wow, like they really had to. Good job proofreading there, DICE, right? They also fixed an issue where an AT mine could count as a vehicle kill, and I think that was the whole thing of the SOFLAM and using the AT mines. They also fixed an issue where the air radar would display a minimap when running on a hardcore server with minimap disabled. And I noticed that a lot whenever I joined some servers, people were complaining about air radar, or the server would say itself, no air radar. And I don't know why people get all butthurt about it. Now, they also fixed an issue where landing a helicopter on a mobile artillery vehicle would make the helicopter invisible. That I did not know. Did not know that whatsoever. But anyways, if you guys would like to check out the rest of the list, I mean, there's a whole crap load of different things that they've done. A lot of it really isn't game breaking, it's just more or less getting the glitchy crap out of the game. Now, I don't know if this is going to be DICE's last update to the game. Obviously, they haven't stated it will be, but Endgame is the very last DLC for Battlefield 3, so what do you think? Are you PS3 users enjoying it? Comment below, hit that like button, tell me. Later.
You are listening to Sotix.